petition by Halifax from Saif, sires.
My strength knows no bounds.
I took to yet me big shuram. Me atena titema. Sotlem to Biber or teken de henyan yes.
Finally, someone's penetrated the deep tombs, and a Sith nonetheless. We're both busy, so I'll be brief. There is a prisoner in your area, immensely powerful, hardened by decades of experimentations, and then left to rot. He is known only as Subject 13. He must be freed and made to serve the Empire.
Sounds like a bad idea to me.
Power demands risk. Surely you aren't averse to a little danger. Whoever or whatever Subject 13 is, he won't bow to the Empire without some convincing. Any Sith could break his shackles, but you alone possess the strength to dominate Subject 13.
I will handle it.
Excellent. Follow the coordinates to Subject 13's cell. Subdue him. Then my apprentice will facilitate his escape. I will await word of the prisoner's liberation.
Horrible car, Doctor. I took to yet me big shuram. Me atena titima. Eh, Temur, Doritelurum, Sabiestentetus, Telebrestia.
No one has to get hurt over this.
Habib his bat semete foke, metainte. Madeos taturis, legicalarum smiet gaenti.
Lord Mogren told me you would be here. I am his apprentice. And Subject 13, you defeated him?
Subject 13 said I had to sacrifice myself for his freedom. That wasn't going to happen.
We can still release him. If this prison permitted his death, he would have killed himself centuries ago. Subject 13, you have been vanquished. Now take my mind and serve the Empire. It is your only choice. Tell Lord Mogren of my glory.
Escaped. Excellent. Subject 13's ancient cell remains a mystery to us, but I apologize for keeping you in the dark this long. At any rate, Subject 13 has assumed control of my apprentice. The shock collar cured the prisoner's initial disobedience. Soon I will direct his wrath against the Republic. The chaos he unleashes shall be in your name.
my lord. You are freed.
Rage. Wrath. Vengeance. I've been dormant too long. I need outlets. Had my brother sent anyone else, I would destroy them for practice. Why did it take Baras so long to discover Belsavis? He must be getting weak.
Baras has ascended to the Dark Council, and with your help, will soon be named the voice of the Emperor.
If my dear brother has everything under control, then where are my assassins?
I sent my commandos to release them. What do you sense?
Before you arrived here, I sensed my assassins being freed. And then someone turned their hearts against me.
I don't know what to say, my lord. I've taken every precaution.
You've grown incompetent in your old age. I believe I will vent my frustrations after all. I will tell your master, my brother, the future voice of the Emperor, that you died like a dog.
You are truly Baras's kin, to betray someone so loyal to you.
It is a family tradition. Now, exactly who are you?
He's with me, Ekkage.
Nomankar's sad little whelp. This just gets better and better. If you're aligned with this Jedi, you are a fool and a traitor.
I am the Emperor's wrath, unleashed by his hand, and the Emperor has marked you and your brother as enemies.
So, the Emperor's hand now works with the Jedi. No wonder my brother defies the Emperor. Baras will be declared the voice of the Emperor. Then he and I shall dominate the Empire. I'm not going to miss that. I just destroyed a lord with a mere flick of my wrist. Don't blink. I'm about to do it again.
We fight together, sir.
Have my powers waned as I languished here?
I've never faced a stronger foe.
Before you get any creative ideas, my friend, help me reseal Darth Ekkage in her cell.
I'm going to let her escape unless you destroy her in cold blood.
What? You can't be serious. Your mission would fail. Darth Baras would get his way.
I'm trying to walk the light path, but my mandate is to kill her. If I fail, my status will be lost. You must kill her so that I remain in good standing and do not grow darker.
If you're walking the light, it's a great advantage to do it secretly from within the Empire. Just as Nomankar did so many years ago to neutralize Ekkage in the first place. It pains me, but I have to do it. I feel less than I was.
It was for the best.
The life of a Jedi is a difficult one, but that was the hardest choice I've faced. I'll have to live with my decision. Now, what's to be between us? Do we part as friends or as enemies?
We fight the same foe. Perhaps when this war is over, we will talk.
I look forward to the opportunity. Good luck to you, Sith.
I'm pleased you parted with him on good terms.
Happy to please you, Jacer. Now, we return to the ship and inform the Hand that the deed is done.
Thank you. I accept all forms of currency. Thank you for your patronage.
Welcome, my lord. Your assistance has proven invaluable, just as the Emperor foresaw. The Dreadmasters are safe. In freeing them, you have truly accomplished the Emperor's vision.
The Dreadmasters have a temper. Try not to anger them.
Naturally. But thank you for the advice. It goes without saying that all events on Belsavis are strictly confidential, especially those pertaining to the Ekkage. But enough formalities. With the Dreadmasters freed, the galaxy will know fear once more. The Emperor thanks you for everything.
My lord, I've been dealing with a situation that's getting out of hand. Moff Broisk contacted the ship and was incensed to find me at the helm. He's been sending recorded messages that are progressively more nonsensical. He's always been scattered and aggressive, but now he seems completely unhinged.
The next time he comes calling, I will speak with the man.
I would appreciate that, my lord. Tens of thousands of soldiers and some of our most critical campaigns are at the mercy of his commands.
The man is a liability.
I find myself agreeing with you.
Got a few leads on the old Black Ops team. Republic won't let the Bastion go easy. It'll take all of us to claim it. Best to start with Lieutenant Tenido, weapons man. Could turn a hyperdrive into a gun turret if he wanted. Let's it all go to his head, of course. Can't open his mouth except to brag about Black Ops and our wins.
I assume he has the talent to back up his talk.
Tenido's a genius. The Bastion will only make him worse. Took a while to track Tenido down, but he's stationed on Hoth. Finally got a clear comm signal today. You're welcome to listen in. After a few months defrosting blasters, Tenido's probably in rare form.
And then he had me forcibly removed from the armory. Over a few flash grenades. Weapons master indeed.
And after you calibrated all the assault rifles for him too. Shame about those cadets though.
Yes, that was unfortunate. But how was I to know those rifles were for training? They really should use slaves. Anyhow, that's how I ended up on Hoth. Scraping ice from blaster barrels and reheating ammunition. Pathetic.
A man of your talent should be on Dromund Kaas.
Oh, if only. The Citadel would be a welcome sight after all this snow and ice.
Maybe you should start tinkering again. Get that weapon you built for the Bastion out of storage.
You know very well that weapon's finished. It's waiting for the assault that will never happen.
The Lieutenant volunteered your entire team.
We've got clearance from General Racton. The Bastion's ours for the taking.
Then it's fallen into place. The Bastion. After all these years. I'll get back to base and start making arrangements. When I have the weapon, I'll contact you.
Tenido doesn't like to waste time. He'll have that weapon quick as a Minox wings. Just in time, too. Let the man idle any longer, and he might do some real damage.
I look forward to seeing Tenido unleashed.
Should be a show. Like to see the size of his head after this one. Tenido's weapons will help, but we'll need more than firepower for this one. Assault this big takes reinforcements, too. Get back to you about those.
Master, one of the Sith I tried to connect to has contacted me. It seems he's ready to trust us. His name is Lord Emmerich. He's an overseer on Korriban who secretly trains hand-selected acolytes to follow the light.
That's the kind of daring we need around here.
I wholeheartedly agree, Master. He is right under the nose of the Dark Council. Emmerich knows he won't last long. And he's hoping we'll look after his disciples, help consolidate their power, and guide them in the galaxy. With your permission, I'd like to reach out to them and keep in contact.
Emmerich's pupils will be a great asset when the day to make our move on the Empire comes.
To be sure. The longer he remains active, the bigger the army he builds for us. You're teaching me to find sustenance from within, independent of outside forces and direct results. And the moment I let go of my need for obvious progress, progress is achieved. This reinforces everything you have told me.
What's on your mind, Brunmark? The thrill of choking off that first life. I'll never forget it. It was your destiny. Without them, you wouldn't serve me now.
I think I'm getting better at this whole fighting thing. Watching you pick targets for all those hours must have been useful after all.
It's nice to see you improving your skills.
Going to be a sharpshooter any day now. You just wait.
The Wrath ascend.
Darth Ekkage will not be joining her brother.
Yes, with Baras's sister silenced, our enemy grows angry. But he has other endeavors that must fail. The key Dark Council member who opposes Baras's attempt to be named Voice of the Emperor is Darth Vauron. Vauron is spearheading the battle for Corellia, and Baras secretly undermines his efforts. He hopes to orchestrate Vauron's failure, or death.
Baras is willing to risk losing Corellia.
His personal goals override the war.
The pendulum swings with Vauron's weight.
Vauron alone holds the Defiant Council members together. Baras's attempts to weaken his Corellia campaign must be thwarted. The Empire's Armageddon Battalion was to be assigned to Corellia, but Baras redirected it to Hoth, where its strength is being wasted. General Greist commands. He must be convinced to abandon Maris's orders and take Armageddon Battalion to Corellia.
Guess I better break out my winter gear again.
I served with General Greist for a time, my lord. as tough as they come, and stubborn.
Resistance cannot be accepted. Armageddon Battalion must be reassigned. Do whatever it takes to make it happen.
Great. Back to the deep freeze.
Hoth is a big place, my lord. It could take a long time to find Greased.
Commander Slint is Baras's man there. He'll know where to find Armageddon Battalion.
Ah, yes. Excellent thinking, my lord. Of course, Baras is rather tough on underlings. Assuming Slint hasn't been disposed of, he's your best lead.
Time to look up an old friend.